Hi, welcome to online digital marketing training. In this video, I'm explaining about how to create Twitter ads. So this is for beginners anyway. In upcoming videos, I'll be explaining more in depth about different Twitter ads. But if you're a beginner, this video will help you a lot. First, let me show you where you will find the Twitter ads, or else if you create Twitter ad, where it will appear. So these are the trending topics, right hand side. If you see, so this is the this trending topic promoted by YouTube. And if you scroll down, Twitter will give you some suggestions like to follow some people. See here also a promoted one coming. And this is the feed actually. Most of the time in the feed also promoted ads will be coming. Okay. So how to create Twitter ads? So go to ads.twitter.com, and if you doing it for the first time, it will ask you country and time zone. Which country and time zone it will be asking you. You can't change it later. If you say America, US, then it will be that. You can't change it anyway. If you want to change it again, you have to create another account. Right. Next, let me explain the process. But before that, same like Google Ads and Facebook, Twitter also follows some account structure. Let me show you the account structure here. So this is the account structure. First, you have to create campaign. Ad group, multiple ad groups can create, and in each ad group multiple creatives you can use for A/B testing. When it comes to campaign, at campaign level, what you will do? You will do nothing. First, you select your objective. What do you mean by objective? So there are different kinds of objective here, like whether you want a brand awareness campaign or else consideration or conversion, same like a Facebook. Like you have a new product and you want to reach more people, then go for this. A video views, in-stream, app install, website clicks, engagement, this selection. If you have an app and you want re-engagement, go for this. I'm going to make separate videos for each and every option given over here. But as of now, this is the basic video. I'm going to show you how this works. I'll be showing the reach one anyway. So if you're not subscribed to my channel, subscribe it so that the remaining videos notification also you'll be getting. Right, so this is the account structure. Yeah, so at the campaign level, you'll be selecting the objective, what you want to do with this, and after that, start and end date, when you want to start, when you want to end, and daily budget and total budget, how much you want to spend. So main thing is in the ad group level. Ad group level also, you're having a start and end date and total budget. Forget about these are optional, but main thing is placement and targeting, where you want to show the ad and whom you want to target. So I'll be covering that. Next, bidding. Finally, we'll be going for the creatives. Now let me create here. I've already have account, ads account. That's why I'm directly coming over here. Here you have an option, create campaign. Click on this. As I explained, account structure first is campaign. So what is your campaign objective? I'm selecting the reach campaign as of now, brand awareness campaign. Okay, see the account structure here, campaign, ad groups and ads. So what is the campaign name? See guys, campaign name, this is for your guidance. If you have 20 campaigns, you should know what is this campaign. That's the reason related to your goals, put the campaign name. Funding source, credit or debit card. And yes, here is the daily budget and the total budget. Depends on your budget mentions. Daily budget $10 and total budget $100. So based on this, by default, this ad will appear for 10 days. $10 per day, total $100. But if you don't want, you want specific days only, you can mention this. I want to show my ad from this date to that date. You can mention that. So here the start and end date available. Here one more option we have advanced, like pacing. How do you want to run the ad, whether it is standard or accelerated? Let it be standard only. If you select standard, your budget will be spent throughout the day. See, show ads throughout the day to spend budget as efficiently as possible. Same like a Google Ads. If it is accelerated, maybe there is a possibility you can finish your ad spend within an hour like this. When this is helpful, like you have an event which is going to end tomorrow, so you want to run this ad as fast as possible, then you can select this. So for time constrained campaigns like major sporting events, show ads as often as possible each day. So depends on the campaign, you can select them. Okay, so first we're done with the campaign. I give a campaign name, a daily budget and total budget. If you want, you can specify the start and end date and standard option. Next is the ad group level. So here, if you want, you can create multiple ad groups also. I'm just creating the ad group first. And here also start and end date is the optional. But if you don't mention what are the campaign details you mentioned, that will be applied here, even the budget also. Here, bidding type. There are two bidding types, automatic bidding and target cost. See, as per my experience, where I work with some of the clients, automatic bidding is much better. So Twitter automatically adjust your bidding. When it comes to target cost, you have to mention. If it is a target cost, you have to mention. Like if you mention like $4.75 and our campaign type is brand awareness, so I want to reach more people, then what Twitter is doing is for 1000 impression, they're charging $4.75. So this works on a CPM based cost per mile, same like Google Ads, cost per thousand. So 1000 times your ad appeared, they're charging $4.75. So here they're trying to reach maximum people. So here they're telling you what is the recommend range. Here one more option is there in the drop down. See, brand awareness intention is to reach more people. Here Twitter will not guarantee you that engagement, someone will like or comment. But if you want engagement, select this. Then see, automatically this price will increase because you're expecting engagement. Now see, the bid range is 8 to 12 now. So in between you have to select it anyway. Then only you'll be getting. So I'm selecting 10. Then for 1000 impression, Twitter will be charging around $10. But make sure that Twitter will give you engagement also, like a comment, retweet kind of thing. You can try both of them. That's what I'm telling you. You do one thing, create two ad groups, one with a automatic bid and another with the target cost. Let's see which one is working for you. So as of now, I'm going with the automatic bid and maximum reach. Now here, one more option called measurement options, audience measurement tag and double click tracking. See, people already visited your website. You want to target them for the remarketing and all these things. This is good. As of now, I'm leaving it. In the next video, I'm going to explain more about this tag, how to set up your global site tag. Okay. Next. Now the targeting. Whom you want to target? So your audience. So you already have a traffic and people came to your website. You want to target them. Select this option. So here you'll be having option called tailor audience, mobile audience, but I'm not going with this because I'm targeting this for the people who doing first time. So you don't have any previous audience to your website. So don't go for this. Once you started the campaign, people are coming to your website, then only go for this kind of thing. In the next video, I'm going to explain how to target the tailor audience. People already came to your website, how to target. As of now, leave it anyway. Now we're targeting the fresh audience. Okay. Target by age. So by default all ages are there, but if you want you can select the range. If you, in Google Ads you can clearly mention like 18 to 21, 18 to 35, any number you can do it, but Twitter they'll be giving the slots like this. You have to select that slots. They mentioned Japan only. I don't know why they mentioned Japan only. Maybe there are some restrictions. That's the reason I'm telling. So I want to target 18 to 49. Depends on your niche. Your product, you can select this. By default, all men and women I'm targeting. Okay, here are a few more targets in there. Which location you want to target? So assume that want to target United States country. If you want, you can target a separate city or metropolitan place also you can target. That much of customization is there. So I selected US. And what else you can target? You can target by OS version, platforms, languages, device models also you can do it. OS version means like iOS or Android or any other device. Platforms, again iOS device, Android device. If you select iOS device, then only for them your ad will be appearing. Next, languages, device models. If you want, you can select the proper device also. I want my ad to be appeared to only Samsung Galaxy A20 people. That option also there. These are all options available in Google Ads and FB Ads also. And even service provider carriers also you can target. This is one targeting method by demographics. Next, scroll down. Here also you can narrow your audience with the help of keywords, events, interest, followers, lookalike, movies, and TV shows. Let me show what is this. First is events. Events means nothing but upcoming one, football match is there, a cricket match is there, and people already showed interest to go there. So you want to target them, you can do it. Let me show you. So you can select a sport, sports or conference, holidays. I selected a sport. Now these are this. UEFA Championship League, Coca-Cola Cup. If you select them, people, so right hand side they give me information. Event targeting reaches people interested in global or regional events. For a full list of upcoming events, see events in the analytics menu. So if you select them, people who are interested in this, they'll be getting it. Interest. So in Google Ads, we have affinity, right? This is also same thing. So people who are interested in sports, home and garden, personal finance, to them, your ad will be appearing. This is a broader category anyway. Next, conversation topics. In Twitter, people will be talking about a topic. Let me select a topic anyway. Selecting something like digital marketing. So digital transformation, digital innovation, sales for marketing, in such a way any related thing you can try it. So target people who tweet about or engage with a specific conversation topics. If you think that is related to your business, you can do this. See guys, these are not mandatory. These are all filters are available. Instead of reaching a broader audience, you want to narrow your audience. So this will help you. Next, followers lookalike. This is very important and this is very good also. Followers lookalike means I'm into digital marketing. I'm training students. Neil Patel, Brian Dean, these are the famous people internationally. So they have some followers, right? They're all digital marketing aspirants. Then what I'll do is, typing Neil Patel. So Neil Patel. So followers lookalike means target people with interests similar to an account followers. So to Neil Patel who are following, for them my ad will appear. They are all digital marketing aspirants, right? If my posts are coming, If they found interesting, there is a possibility I can get more subscribers from them. They are my target customers. In the same way, in your niche, who are your competitors? So put their name and target the followers of that guy. This will help you a lot. Keywords. Keywords is nothing but people searching for, in Twitter also searching, who are actively searching for that. Let me type digital marketing. See, target or exclude people who search for, tweet with, or engage with the keywords. If I select them, people who are talking about this, I'm going to target. This is good anyway. See, now it's showing the recommendation. 1.5 million to 1.8 million possibilities there. Okay, so remember, we targeted with the demographics, age and gender, and location. Now here, we target with the help of keywords, events, interest, followers, lookalike. Next, one more option is there. Movies and TV shows also. Like you like Madam Secretary, that is a TV show. You want to target the people who are following this, you can do it. If you think this is good, you can do it. Target people who tweet about or engage with movies and TV shows in a specific market. So there are many targeting options available. Okay, right, this is one thing. Scroll down. Again, I'm telling you, this is not mandatory. If you don't select anything by default, based on the location, whoever have the Twitter accounts, your ad will be reaching. So it's not mandatory, but whenever you use it, then what happened? You're narrowing your audience so that you're reaching the target customers. So it's always advisable to use these filters. Then there are some more options like recommendation. This is the most popular hashtags and usernames used in the last 7 days by people matching the demographics you selected. If you want, you can do, but not required. I suggest not do it. But here, an option is there. Retargeted people who saw or engaged with your past tweets. Means people already following your tweets and they're engaging with you. So to them, your ad will go. Next, retargeting type. People who saw your tweets or people who saw engage with your tweets. You can select any one option. Tweet type, organic tweets. Or else a paid tweet also you can select. Finally, expand your audience. Defined, expanded, and broad. If you select this means you'll be reaching more people. You have a lot of marketing budget, then only select it. Otherwise, make it too defined only. Right. And if you click on the additional options, there is an option called also target followers of Subhash Mangalam. Your handle will come. Means, assume that you have 40,000 followers. For them only you want to show the ad, then don't select any one of them. Directly come here and select this. So for all your followers, your ad will come in. So you will be having question. If already people are following your account, then why you need ads? See, 40,000 people following your Twitter account, it doesn't mean that your tweet will go to them. Some people might not be live on the time. So whenever they open the Twitter account, other news will be coming on the feed. So there is a possibility that they'll be missing it. In such case, you can select it. But if you want to activate it, minimum 1,000 followers you should have, then only this option will work. Right. So I selected a campaign objective, budget, the same. I mentioned the targeting methods also, whom I want to target. Next is the creative. See, creatives are very important, guys. See, these are some sample ads other people have used. See, this is a ad of the drink coffee. All the cool kids are doing it. Why aren't you? Nobody wants. And this is one. This is one. These are more of a video ads. This will come as a promoted ads. So I'll make a separate video on how to make proper ads. Okay. See, when it comes to creating ads, you already made. See, today I already made these are the tweets. If you want, you can use any one of them as your ad. Select any one of them and that will become your ad. So these are all the organic tweets. Or else you want to create a separate one, then here there is an option, create tweet. When you click on that, new tab will be opened. Select it. Or else you do one thing, before you go for ad, come back to Twitter account, make a proper tweet which is targeting the ad. If not directly, you can create here. So I'll show the difference between this. So this is the normal Twitter account, this is the ad account. When you want a tweet, you can add 280 characters at the same time, image, GIF, poll, emojis. But when you come here under Twitter ads, under creatives, you have image, video, poll, and card also there. These are called Twitter cards. Okay, one second. I'm gonna tell you what is Twitter card. Twitter card is nothing but predefined images, videos. You can use it to make it as an ad. That's it. So if you want to create new, come back here, creatives, cards. I want to create a website card. Someone click on that, they should come to my website. Writing enroll for e-learning and website URL. Card name. This is for your reference anyway. And select the image. What image you want to add. Okay. Assume that I'm using this. This will become a card. And anytime you can use this in your ad. Like see here. Now when I click on this. Now you can select a card. And I'm using this card. Now you can write whatever you want. Then tweet. So there are two options, guys. Whenever you tweet it, this will not be visible to the your followers. This will be only promoted ads. So here option is the promoted ads. If you unselect this, it will be going as a promoted ad. At the same time, your follower also will be getting a tweet. It's better not to go for this. Tweets. Done, guys. Then next. One second. Yeah. Placement. By default, all placements are better. User's timeline, profile, search results. So initially I show you right where your ad will appear. User's timeline. When you click on any person, I'm assuming that I'm selecting this guy. So when you seeing his timeline also, see, here is one promoted ad is appearing. This is one way. And profiles and search results. Someone searching the results also, your ad will appear. So by default, all options is much better. Yes, everything is done. It's an overview now. What is your campaign? We selected a reach, start and end date, daily budget, total budget, and pacing is standard. And this is the ad group details. I selected automatic bidding and maximum reach. So total audience size based on filters is 1.5 million to 1.8 million. You can narrow down if you select more options over there. And finally, your creative and launch campaign. Then pay from debit or credit card so that your ad will be live. And once your ad is live, you will be getting analytics also. How the campaign is performing, how it is performing. That's it, guys. I'm going to make a separate video for all these things. how to run a brand awareness campaign, and how to increase followers with the help of Twitter ads, how to increase video views, how to increase app installs also, and how to increase traffic and engagement. So make sure that you subscribe to this channel so that you'll be getting a notification on the upcoming videos also. And I'll be working on the live campaigns. I will show you the analytics, how it is working. And if you have any questions on how to create Twitter ad, please put a comment so that I'll be replying back to you. When you're doing a live campaign also, watch this video, parallelly do it. Still, if you have any questions, put a comment, or else you can send me mail to this email ID, subhashmangalam786@gmail.com. Okay, guys. A small revision again, I'm telling you. So first, before you going live, have a campaign structure first. What kind of campaign I'm creating? What is my objective? And where I want to target? What is my creative? Everything is ready, then only go live. Okay? Right, guys. Thank you very much.